Happy birthday to Ludwig van Beethoven. It's 250 years since he was born, and with me to celebrate is classical composer Keith Burstein. Hello, Keith.
Hello, yeah.
Well, not just to celebrate, but you've kind of done something about it, about Beethoven's 250th birthday. You wrote a special piece of music for him.
That's right, yes.
Well, I was inspired by him.
I was invited to write a symphonic poem by Vladimir Ashkenazy, the celebrated conductor and pianist. And shortly after he asked me to do that, I found myself in Bonn in Germany, which is the birthplace of Beethoven.
Right.
Actually to hear another work of mine there. And it was a brief visit, but while I was there, having had a tour of the town and seen the beautiful Rhine, which sweeps through Bonn, and seen the hills beyond, I don't know whether I was inspired by that, but I suddenly heard this kind of high trumpet call.
You heard it, or you had it in your...
It was like a kind of sound vision or something very subliminal, you know, almost beyond perception. But it was quite nevertheless distinct, and distinct enough for me to think, ah, I think I'll make that the beginning of my piece for Maestro Ashkenazy. And then I gradually, as I was working on that, I gradually began to think, actually, I think this work will have to fit into the 2020 celebrations, because, you know, I was inspired to write it by the city, and the city is the birthplace of Bonn, of Beethoven, and this was in 2016, so there's been quite a long pathway from there to the performance, which is on the 25th of March.
Right.
At the Cadogan Hall by the London Chamber Orchestra.
Right. And there are about 40 or so players?
That's
musicians?
Right, yes.
Which so it's a large-scale-ish?
It is, actually, yes. I mean, 40 players is not the biggest orchestra, but you can make it sound huge if you write in a certain way, and I'm quite good at doing that. And so, looking forward to that.
Yes. Yeah. So that sounds quite romantic in a way. So you went to Bonn for only 24 hours or so. You were inspired by the place. You wrote a piece, and now it's going to be performed for the anniversary. How similar is the piece to Beethoven's actual music?
Well, obviously, you know, this is 250 years later since he was born, so the world has moved on, and we've come through, and I think we're just coming out of the period of atonal modernism, which was the kind of experimental phase of classical music, where composers experimented with writing in a very unmelodic way and allowing almost random musical events, a bit like experimental jazz.
Right.
You know, sort of like that.
Okay, so I wanted to talk to you about that kind of discussion, nearly controversial kind of argument between musicians, composers, of tonal, atonal music, but just to give us a little bit of an idea of perhaps your music in particular and the kind of more tonal type of music. Let's listen to something that you've written. It's an opera. Do you want to just give me a little gist of what it's about?
Yeah, this is an opera called The Prometheus Revolution, and it imagines a kind of spiritual revolution in Britain, where we move out of the era dominated by war and greed, and we move into an era dominated by ideas of humanitarianism and compassion and the environment.
Okay, let's have a little listen.
Tonality,
compromise, that's a good, or, you know, encompassing.
Well, it's encompassing and it's generously inclusive. You know, I think that's the way I would describe it. It's a way of thinking and feeling which lovingly brings all the achievements of the past with us.
Lovely. Okay. It's kind of quite amusing to think that classical musicians sort of fight over this tonal and atonal debate, but it's also what keeps it alive. So once more, can you just tell me give me the details of your coming concert?
Sure, yes. My piece is called Memories of Bonn, and that's going to be played by the London Chamber Orchestra in the Cadogan Hall at 7:30 on the 25th of March.
And if people want to find out online about it, presumably they just Google Cadogan Hall.
They Google Cadogan Hall or London Chamber Orchestra.
Right. Yeah. Keith, thank you so much and good luck.
Thanks very much, yeah.